greetings. Thank you, Brother Zahur, for your prolific list of incorrect understanding. Many of your claims are logically fallacious, brother. That means they are wrong and based on unsound assumption or baseless assertions. You wrote Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him, is the most successful among all the prophets of God. I understand you wish to force this claim as if it were valid, brother. In all truth, Muhammad is more important to you than your Allah. But let's look at your list of support for your claim to defend Muhammad. 1. He was tried to kill several times in his lifetime by pagan Arabs and by Jews. I myself can pinpoint at least 5 major incidents where there is master plan made to kill him. That is not a basis to claim a prophet is supported by God, brother. Muhammad had armies of men defending him and mindlessly willing to die supporting him. Those who would not submit, Muhammad had killed. As such a violent man, it is no surprise many would wish to kill him. President Ronald Reagan had 2 unsuccessful attempts on his life, but that did not make him a prophet of God. He was successful in bringing down his very enemies who drove him out of his city and capturing and conquering the primary and major city of idolaters, Mecca, starting from zero and changing the whole of Arabia in his deathbed. There was not a single idolater who could preach idolatry in the whole of Arabia. Again, this is not a basis to claim prophethood or support by God. He was supported in the first major battle with pagan and had a tremendous victory over them. Even their number were very less, 313 Muslims unarmed versus 1,000 pagan idolaters in successive battles to perform later. Many battles by Israel are far superior to this claim, brother. Prophet Elisha did not even have to kill a single man. 2 Kings 6:18. As the enemy came down toward him, Elisha prayed to the Lord, "Strike this army with blindness." So he, God, struck them with blindness, as Elisha had asked. Now, brother, that right there is God supporting a prophet. You worship Mars, a demon of violence, and think that is great. Then Elisha said to them, "This is not the way, nor is this the city. Follow me, and I will bring you to the man whom you seek." And he brought them to Samaria. When they had come into Samaria, Elisha said, "O Lord, open the eyes of these men that they may see." So the Lord opened their eyes, and they saw, and behold, they were in the midst of Samaria. They were now prisoners. See, brother, that is God hearing a prophet. Immediately. Muhammad was nothing but a violent pagan warlord. Jesus, peace be on him, says, "I came to my own and my own did not receive him." And a lot of questions like a what the? Absolutely, brother, just as the prophets of God foretold. Isaiah 28:16. So this is what the sovereign Lord says. "See, I lay a stone in Zion, a tested stone, a precious cornerstone for a sure foundation. The one who relies on it will never be stricken with panic." Psalm 118:22, "The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone." Luke 20:17, Jesus looked directly at them and asked, "Then what is the meaning of that which is written? The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone." Isaiah 53:3, "He was despised and rejected by men, a man of suffering who knew what sickness was. He was like someone people turned away from. He was despised, and we didn't value him." You see, brother, the prophets foretold the Messiah's purpose and fate. You make your mistake because you are spiritually blind, brother, and in darkness. You follow a false path that prizes violence and rejects God's prophets. Jesus, peace be on him, and his followers were humiliated and killed as per their belief? Yes, indeed, brother. And doesn't that just damn the Quran to hell as a lie? Surah 355 states your Allah would make those who follow Jesus superior superior, superior, above and not beneath, superior, unto the day of resurrection. But Jesus, peace be upon him, and his followers were humiliated and killed, as per their belief. There is no way to fix the lie Surah 355 tells, my friend. It is a lie, and a damned lie. Your own words prove the Quran false. 6. The followers of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him, in less than 12 years had tremendous victory over the superpower of that time. The Roman Empire, the Persian Empire, both lands fell down to Muslim Syria, Iraq, Iran, Palestine, Jerusalem, and Egypt. I believe Alexander the Great conquered more, faster, at a younger age. That makes him a greater prophet than Muhammad, right, brother? At the deathbed, Prophet, peace be on him, saw one lakh, which is 100,000. Muslim accepted Islam compared to Jesus, peace be on him, only 12 companions. How many companions did Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him, had more than 100,000? And on, I think they need to read the history again. Violence and compulsion. No proof of God's involvement, brother. Not one atom of support from God. You are free to hold on to whatever fantasy comforts you, brother. God has foretold the fate of those who do not love the truth. However, you have the chance to examine the error of each wrong point you made, mistaking man's violence with support by God. I do not dispute Muhammad was a violent warlord who successfully conquered nomadic tribes in the Arabian Peninsula. I do not dispute Muhammad used promise of eternal sex orgies to convince men to fight to the death for him. That does not make him a prophet of God. Rather, he is a very good schemer. Perhaps the Al-Makr. Ultimately, brother, your perception that God supported Muhammad is based on error. The error that Muhammad's violent wars and marauding indicates spiritual support. Perhaps it does, but from Satan, a violent and evil force in the earth. But nothing like the God that won the war with Elisha without harming a single man. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.